today's review from BBC Learning English.
Hello and welcome to News Review, the program where we show you how to use the language from the latest news stories in your everyday English. I'm Dan, and joining me today is Catherine. Hi, Catherine.
Hi, Dan.
So, what's the story about this week?
Well, today's story, Dan, is from the world of medicine, and we're looking at how scientists have given an old favourite a major upgrade.
A story about an old favourite being given a major upgrade. Interesting. OK, let's hear more from this report from the World Service.
Scientists say they've created a groundbreaking new version of a life-saving antibiotic. They say the discovery will boost their battle against infections that are resistant to antibiotics, one of the biggest threats to global health. The researchers in the United States modified an existing medicine, vancomycin, making it about 1,000 times more powerful.
So, a story from the United States there. Now, antibiotics are a medicine that we all know, used a lot. They're very powerful in fighting infections, but recently they've become less powerful because bacteria are getting stronger and more resistant. However, American scientists have found a way to take an old antibiotic and make it much, much, much more powerful. If that's true, it'll be good news for everyone.
Certainly, yeah, good news for everybody in the fight against superbug resistance. Okay, so you've been looking around at the news and you've chosen three words and expressions that we need to understand and talk about this story. What are they?
We have hail, supercharge and packs a punch.
Hail, supercharge and packs a punch. Okay, Catherine, what's your first headline, please?
Okay, so we'll go to the Daily Record and the headline is Scientists hail magical antibiotic which gives hope in battle against disease.
Okay, hail meaning publicly praise. Quite a newsy word to start with.
Yes, it is. I mean, it's one of those things that's really short. It's four letters long. Newspapers love short words, but yeah, it's very newsy. Although the original, when I hear the word hail, I always think of the phrase Hail Caesar, which is from a long time ago, but Emperor Caesar of Rome. His citizens, soldiers, people who loved him and respected him and obeyed him said the phrase Hail Caesar to mean we love you, we like you, we respect your power. So it's about praising.
Okay, so it's a way of showing respect. But is it something that I'd say to my friends?
Well, if you were friends with Caesar, the Roman emperor. But probably not normally, no. There's lots of different ways the word hail, you can respect your friend, you can approve of them, you can like them, you can big them up. There's lots of different things we say, but no, not for spoken English so much.
Okay, thank you very much. All right, on to our second headline then.
Okay, and we've got the new Atlas. Scientists supercharge old antibiotic in fight against bacterial resistance.
Supercharge, to make more powerful. Tell us about that. It's a great word.
It is. Great word. Super and charge. Now, super is used as a prefix. In this case, a prefix means more. Charge we use in the sense of you charge your phone, you give energy to something. So if you supercharge something, you give it more power and more energy.
Okay, cool. If I'm not mistaken, it comes from engineering?
That's right, yes. It was originally used when engineers made their engines more powerful, especially in car engines. It supercharged them to make them go faster and stronger. Okay. But it's migrated to everyday English use now. So you can supercharge pretty much anything, actually.
Okay.
For example, I think, your breakfast. I saw you looking very, very sprightly and perky this morning.
Yes. Do you want to know what the secret is?
I do.
I supercharge my breakfast porridge with chia seeds.
Wow. Well, yeah. They're certainly working, Dan.
They give you a lot of energy. They've got great protein in them. I recommend it to everybody out there.
Brilliant.
Supercharge your breakfast. All right, let's migrate onto our third headline then, shall we?
Okay, and this time we're looking at fizz.org. New antibiotic packs a punch against bacterial resistance.
Packs a punch, has great effect or power. Now, Catherine, it might just be the chair, but I'm confused. I thought packing was to do with suitcases.
You're quite right, Dan, it is. Yes, we all like to pack suitcases when we're going on journeys. And when you pack your case, you put things in it. You fill it up. So this actually packs a punch comes from the world of boxing. And when a boxer puts his or her fist in the glove, they're packing this glove with a powerful fist. So pack a punch. To pack a punch means to do something really powerful and effective.
Wonderful. Okay. And is this a metaphor that you can use only in boxing, or does it apply to lots of different things?
Again, it goes, you can use it all over the place. It's, headlines love it because it's quite kind of dramatic and it's got the alliteration put and put for packs a punch. Mm-hmm. But you can use it with anything. Your breakfast probably packed a punch this morning.
It's certainly got a lot of power in it, that's for true. What about you and chilies? I'm sure you mentioned something about chilies earlier.
I do like a chili. I do like a nice hot chili, and I had one just the other week and oof, it nearly blew my head off. It packs a punch, yes.
Wow,
something
okay.
Powerful and effective. You can use it for documentaries. Maybe you're watching a film on TV. Mm-hmm. It has an effect on you. You can't stop thinking about it. You can say that film packed a punch.
Wonderful. Well, let's hope that our words and phrases have packed a punch with our audience. Now, before we recap them, let's go to our Facebook challenge. Earlier, we posted, American scientists have developed a groundbreaking antibiotic to use against bacterial infections. But what does groundbreaking mean? A, causing the ground to crack. B, a new development with significant consequences. Or C, the result of many hours of hard work. Well, Catherine, how did they do?
Everybody did really well. I don't think many people got it wrong at all. So well done to everyone, including Fiona Ancora, Alberto Taloni, and Mohammed A. Abdu Hadida, who said, my answer is B, a new development with significant consequences, because if something is groundbreaking, it is new and will introduce new ideas, and in this case, it will be effective against bacterial resistance, I think.
Wow, it's quite a comprehensive answer.
Very good answer. Thank you very much, Mohammed, and everyone.
Well done, Mohammed. Good. Okay, everybody. So, could you please recap the vocabulary for us, Catherine?
I will. We had hail, which means publicly praise, supercharge, make more powerful, and packs a punch, meaning has great effect or power.
Thank you very much. Well, if you'd like to test yourself on today's vocabulary, there's a quiz that you can take on our website, bbclearningenglish.com, and you'll also find awesome videos, loads of activities and other things to help you improve your English. Thank you very much for joining us, and bye-bye.
Goodbye.
News review from BBC Learning English.